We will solve Irodov problem 153. It's a very interesting problem. What is given is two masses connected by a spring and a thread such that the free length of the spring has been compressed by delta. So this is the initial position which is given. This is the compression in the spring. When you release it, means when you burn the thread, this spring will release the energy and it will start moving upwards. When it reaches here, it is the position where there is no compression or extension in the spring. Beyond this position, say if it reaches the position this, at this position, say the extension is H. Up to this at this point there is no extension, no compression in the spring, but once it has crossed this, say the distance is H and this be the extension in the spring. Let us apply the energy equation. We have to find out the value of initial compression such that the mass at the bottom gets lifted. The mass at the bottom will get lifted moment you have extension in the spring K delta equal to mg. When you have delta extension in the string, delta extension in the string, it is L0 plus delta is the length of the spring, delta is extension, then this force will act on the mass which can lift it when delta is equal to mg upon k. So this is the first and the foremost thing. So to lift the lower mass, the H should be equal to at least mg upon k. So the initial compression should be such that at least it rises back to this height. And let us apply the energy equation. Now the initial energy is half k delta square. That's gets converted into this energy in extension. You have to take beyond this equilibrium position, that is no extension position, no compression position of the spring. Now the spring will store energy equal to half k h square, plus there has been lifting of the mass by mgh, the potential energy has risen. What else has happened in this process? The energy of the spring has been converted into this energy of the spring plus the height risen by the mass, plus this energy also has been used, means the mass has been lifted from here, that is mg delta. We could have written it straight away, mgh plus delta is the rise in potential energy from this position to this position. This is delta is the initial compression, here the compression vanishes, extension takes place. So the weight has been lift, mass has been lifted from here to here, that is why it's mgh plus delta. But for spring we will take only kh square, not kh plus delta whole square, that would be wrong. The energy of the spring is taken only from for the deformed part. One deformed part we have already taken. Now the next deformed part happens on the way upwards. This is only H. So that is an important aspect which should be kept in mind. Now mg is equal to kh, so that the mass can be lifted. So put the value of H is mg upon k in this equation. You get k upon 2. Delta square is equal to k upon 2 m square g square upon k square plus m g square g square upon k plus m g delta. can solve this equation, it becomes 3 upon 2 m square g square upon k plus mg delta, it is k upon 2 delta square, divide the whole thing by k, it becomes k square, it becomes k, and it is 1 upon 2 delta, multiply by 2 also, it becomes like this, and put mg upon k is equal to alpha. For convenience, this equation becomes delta square is equal to 3 alpha square plus twice alpha delta. So it is a quadratic equation, delta square minus twice alpha delta minus 3 alpha square is equal to 0. You can solve it as a quadratic equation. It comes delta square minus 3 alpha delta plus alpha delta minus 3 alpha square is equal to 0. Delta square plus alpha delta minus 3 alpha delta minus 3 alpha square is equal to 0. Take delta common, you get delta plus alpha minus 3. Take alpha common, you get delta plus alpha is equal to 0. So you get delta plus 3 alpha into delta plus alpha is equal to 0. This is ignored because delta cannot be negative. So this is minus 3 alpha. So we get value of delta is equal to 3 alpha. This is the minimum value of delta for the lower mass to get lifted. So at least the upper mass should rise to the height h. This is the minimum value required. So delta should be greater than equal to 3 mg upon k is the answer to the part 1. Now let us take the part 2, which is slightly complicated. Part 2, we have to find out to what height the center of mass of the system will rise if the initial compression is 7 mg upon k. This is the initial compression, and up to what height it will rise. In this case, it will rise beyond this height also. This height was mg upon k, and this happened when the delta was 3 mg upon k. Now delta is 7 mg upon k, so it will rise further beyond this height, and let this height be h, be this height. Now how to solve this problem? Now we can first solve up to this point, means when the lower mass starts getting lifted. Let us solve in two part. Let us solve when it has risen height h, where h is mg upon k. This was 7 mg upon k given. It has released this much of energy. It has come to this level, that is mg upon k, at the point when the lower mass starts get lifted. We have to find what is the velocity here of this mass at the time when the lower mass also starts getting lifted. So solve for the part 1. So delta half k delta square is the initial energy, which is equal to the energy released up to this point. It is mg delta plus h plus half k h square is the energy which is now stored in the spring in form of extension, plus half mv square. Some velocity will be here because it is not the end point. Here it has more energy, so it is rising further, so there is some velocity v here. Unlike the previous part, where we took this as the maximum lift. There V was taken 0, here V cannot be taken 0, some velocity is there. H is equal to mg upon k, place the value here in this equation. It is 1 upon 2k, delta is how much? 7 mg, so it is 49 m square g square upon k, cancel the k square, is equal to mg into 7 m square g square upon k. I have placed the value of delta plus value of h is mg upon k, so it is m square g square upon k plus half k is what? Mg upon k is value of h, I am putting that value, plus half mv square. So the equation now boils down to 49 upon 2 m square g square upon k is equal to 7 plus 1, 8 m square g square upon k plus, this is how much? This is 1 upon 2 m square g square upon k, remove this, and plus half mv square. Divide this, multiply the whole thing by 2, you get 49 m square g square upon k is equal to 16 m square g square upon k plus m square g square upon k plus mv square. You get mv square is equal to 17 is this, so it becomes 32 m square g square upon k. So velocity is equal to under root 32 m g square upon k is the velocity of this mass. Now here comes the crucial points which we should note very carefully. Just let me take the concept of center of mass little bit. If there are two masses which are connected and you give certain velocity v to this mass, the upper mass, and when both the masses start moving together, the velocity of center of mass would be m plus m is equal to the initial velocity is mv, this velocity was 0, plus m0. So velocity of center of mass would be velocity of this, if m1 this is m2, it will be m1 v1 upon m1 plus m2. So the velocity of this is the velocity of this mass, but I want velocity of center of mass. Velocity of center of mass will be this, which would be nothing but since m1 m2 are same, it will be this upon 2. So velocity of center of mass is 1 upon 2, 32 m g square upon k. This is the velocity of center of mass, means now I have taken this as a combined system. After this point, I have taken this as a combined system. It is moving as a combined system. So this system will gain height, means the height gained by the center of mass after this point, because this is the velocity here. So after this point, let us now convert into energy equation. Half twice m is the mass of the system, v center of mass square is equal to twice m g, h is the height gained by the center of mass. This is not the height gained by this mass, but height gained by the center of mass. H is equal to then twice m gets cancelled, 1 upon 2 into v center of mass square means 1 upon 4 into 32 mg G square upon K. This is nothing but 4 M G square upon K under root. This we have squared MGH. Yes, G gets cancelled. So this is the height gained by center of mass. What is the height of the center of mass at this, up to this point? How much height center of mass has gained? What was the initial height of center of mass? If the initial length of the spring compressed after compression was L0, the center of mass was at L0 upon 2. And here, the after L0, the total extension which has taken upward was L0 plus delta plus mg upon k. It was 8 mg upon k was the height which increased of the upper mass. How much height we will say the center of mass gained? The height gained by center of mass will be, height of the center of mass will be half of this, because it will be midway between these two masses. Initially it was L0 upon 2. The upper mass has gone this much. The total distance between the two masses now is L0 plus 8 mg upon k. So center of mass will be at this much. So the height gained by center of mass up to this point was minus L0 upon 2, which was initial. So the height gained by center of mass up to this point was 4 mg upon k. That is the height gained by center of mass up to this point. Beyond this point, this is the height gained. So total height gained by center of mass will be 8 mg upon k. Please do this problem 2-3 times and the clarity will itself emerge. Thank you.